Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today's discussion is going to be on another requirement of SA200. We had already discussed in the previous lectures about professional skepticism, and also we had discussed about independence and the code of ethics. And today we're going to discuss about third requirement of SA200, obtaining sufficient and appropriate audit evidence. So basically guys, audit evidence should be sufficient and appropriate. Now the question comes in, what do you mean by sufficient? What do you mean by appropriate? So sufficiency refers to the quantity of audit evidence. How much quantity? Okay. So quantity of audit evidence. Appropriateness refers to quality. How is this working? Is it good quality, bad quality? So is the audit evidence of good quality, reliable quality or not? So audit evidence should be what? Sufficient also. There's lots of quantity should be there. And quality also should be there, appropriate also should be there. So audit evidence should be sufficient and appropriate. Why? To reduce something. If it is sufficient, appropriate, to reduce what? Audit risk. To reduce audit risk to acceptably low level. Why do you say acceptably low level? Because of the inherent limitations of audit. What is the inherent limitation of audit? That you are going to do test checking. 100% checking you are not going to do. So obviously you might miss out on something. This is the inherent limitation of audit. That any audit, you cannot say that you are doing full 100% absolute assurance. You are not going to be doing that. You are only going to be giving reasonable assurance. So this is the inherent limitation of audit. So because of that, you cannot say that audit risk will be zero. Audit risk cannot be reduced to zero because of what? Inherent limitation of audit. Okay guys, so basically audit evidence should be sufficient and appropriate to reduce what? The audit risk to acceptably low level. Acceptably low level because it cannot be zero. That's why you're saying acceptably low level. Lowest possible. Acceptably low level. It cannot be zero, but okay. Now what is audit risk might be engaging in your mind? What is material misstatement might be engaging in your mind? And what is inherent limitations of audit might be engaging in your mind? You might be having doubts now, right? So this has been covered in a separate video. If you have not watched this video, please go and watch that video. It's made in a PowerPoint presentation very cleanly. It's a very good video. It will help you understand about audit risk, material misstatements and inherent limitation of audit in detail. But here I'm going to give you a gist about audit risk alone. So basically guys, you're an auditor of a company. You are a CAA. Okay. So the CAA, you're going to A limited company. You're going to do audit. Okay, when you go to do audit, he gives you the financial statements. There is some problem with the financial statements. They are materially misstated. Materially misstated means that misstatement, the material you say, because it might affect the economic decision of the users of the financial statements. So it might affect the economic decisions of the users of the financial statements. That's why it calls material misstatement. After that, what happens is the auditor, that is you, by mistake what? Express an inappropriate audit opinion. Because of which what happens? That has an impact on the economic decision of the user. Because of your opinion, he tends to think the company is doing well and he buys the shares of that company. But eventually, the shares will come down and he loses money. So basically, audit risk means what? It means that the auditor expresses an inappropriate opinion. Inappropriate audit opinion. When the financial statements are materially misstated. Okay. And audit risk cannot be reduced to zero because of the inherent limitation of audit. So basically, what is obtaining sufficient appropriate audit evidence? Audit evidence should be sufficient and appropriate to reduce the audit risk to acceptably low level. Should be sufficient and appropriate to reduce the audit risk to acceptably low level. Sufficiency means quantity of audit evidence. Appropriateness means quality of audit evidence. For understanding the detailed meaning of audit risk, material misstatement and inherent limitations of audit, please do go watch my previous video which I have discussed in this topic in detail. So guys, thank you so much. This was a very quick video on the third requirement of SA200. So please do like, share, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done it. Please press the bell icon for further notifications from this channel. And also keep supporting guys. Keep leaving your thoughts in the comment box. It really helps to understand if I'm going right or wrong. And please leave your video suggestions down. Thank you guys. Bye.